Hello and welcome to this video. I'm going to show you what replication is with Veeam. Replication is one of the core principles of Veeam Backup and Replication, part of the Veeam data platform. And it's also visible throughout other products like the Veeam Recovery Orchestrator. Setting up a replication job is really easy. You can do that with the Veeam Community Edition, and we'll put a link at the top of the post that you can download straight away, or a trial as well. Either way, head on over to veeam.com to get a look at the product. But I want to show you how easy it is to set up a replication job. Let's jump into the lab. Okay, so what I'm looking at is the console, Veeam Backup and Replication, and just that, and replication. So a replication is a different type of recovery option. There are two types of replication with Veeam. The first is a traditional replication, which I'll set up for you here in a second. And the other is a CDP policy, which is a continuous data protection policy for recovery options up to 2 seconds. Very easy to do. That one is VMware only, but you can build a policy right there. Or a traditional replication with a virtual machine. Let's do this. So let's make a name for the replication job. So I'm just going to call it Cyber Recovery Assets because I am in the business of keeping my assets recoverable. So a replication job has a few options. And as you look at this wizard here, the sections will change based on what I might select here with some of these advanced controls. For example, if I know that in the second site, I'm going to have a network IP change, you'll see that that re-IP just popped in right there. Or if I'm going to do seeding to backups that are already in place, an option is placed there. So if I already have off-site backups, I can build the replica based on the backups already on the second site. And then also if there's different virtual networkings from a like production network name, I can select that as well. Each of these are environmentally dependent, so I'm going to skip those. But basically, this is the base replication job here. Oh, and I could optionally select high priority, which is really attractive if you have a specific workload that you truly must have for disaster recovery. So let's click next. Now, I'm going to add to this a number of different options. And for those of you who are VMware admins, these might be very familiar. Host and clusters, virtual machines and templates, data stores, and tags. I'm going to build it based on tags. So in this environment, I have a category of tags here called Cyber Recovery Assets. So this is just a catch-all type of tier one set of applications. It's not huge. I have around 6 virtual machines in here, but nonetheless, the tags and categories scale very well. One of the things you can do is select some exclusions and sources. These are really important options. If I click an exclusion, I could say, if I expand this, for example, and if I look just at the VMs inside of it, maybe I don't want all of these resources displayed. Like for example, if I want to only do systems 1 through 5 and not all 6 of them, I have that opportunity. And how you would do that is you would show the full hierarchy and you would say, for example, I know that number 6 on this environment right here, I want to exclude that one. Like maybe that one isn't subject to DR, isn't super important. You could build an exclusion like that. Or if you have like a disk arrangement that you don't care about, specifically a virtual machine disk, you can exclude that as well. So some nice options there. I'm going to cancel that and still just take them all. The other important option here is the sources. Now, this is really, in my opinion, a big deal. So let me explain this. The default option is to build a replica from the running production storage, the actual state of those 6 virtual machines. So what does that mean? Well, I recommend you still also have a backup. But if you're doing a replication, that means those same virtual machines will have the replication job process against them. So if you're concerned about backup windows, you might want to think about this second option here, which is sourcing the replicas from the backup repositories. So those files on disk, those can actually be used to create the replicated virtual machine on your second site. So that's really attractive if you're concerned about the amount of read I/O on your primary environment. And let's just say I know for a fact I have this backed up in my scale out backup repository, double play immutable target. So what this is going to do is rebuild those six machines in the second site from the backups I already have. Now, where is my second site? So in here, I can go select that, and I can identify where in the infrastructure it's going to sit. And I'm just going to pick a cluster. I'm going to pick a host, 02. I can identify what resource pool and then what folder and what data store these are going to live on. I'm going to put it in the right spot just for consistency. Now, this is my workspace here, but maybe a best practice would be a folder around disaster recovery assets or something like that. I really recommend using good organization naming constructs in your environment to avoid potentially something that isn't so clear when you need to use it. So I'll go ahead and put it in there. And then I can designate what primary storage resources that is the one that I want, and that has enough space, so that's good. Now, one of the important job settings here is this notion of replica metadata. Now, this is not a backup, even though it's identifying backup repositories, but metadata is really just some low-level information about the replicas. By default, it's selected the first available repository, but I don't want to put anything extra on the C drive here for space concerns, so I have a generic NFS system that I'll put the replica metadata on. Now, the next question is a restore point. Now, a restore point is an individual point in time that these systems can be reverted to in a failover job. So think of backups and recoveries, think of replicas and failovers. Restore points, by default, are 7, and if this runs daily, that would be roughly a week of restore points to keep. Now, if I remember right, I think I can only have 28, yes, as a max, and that's because there's a limit to how many virtual machine snapshots you can have, and then on top of that, during the process of failing over and doing a backup job, there are some temporary snapshots taken. You also don't want to really approach this limit. So really for most environments, 14 or less from a day's perspective makes sense, or just keep that in mind. And then the other kind of organizational thing you can put in here is a suffix. So this is going to be put on the end of the name of the virtual machines. By default, you'll see that it had replica there, right? That was the name that it started with. And then I put tier 1 DR in there as well to make it really align something that means more information to my business. And then on the advanced options, really similar to a backup job, you have some specific options to enhance the performance. One of the things by default is to exclude the swap files, which aren't really needed on a replica because they'll be recreated anyways. The compression on the traffic, by default, optimal is ready selected and it's the best option. You can increase it, but that will take more CPU. I recommend some email notifications at a minimum. You could also do SNMP and other notifications. Some quiescence. You could also integrate with our storage snapshots. So if you have a integrated storage system, this will really take the load off the production environment. And it's there by default. If you have any type of before or after script that would be a good idea to run, you could configure that as well. And then the credentials for it, if needed. So I'm going to select all of that and then go to next. And by default, it's going to push this over the network. Now, you can set some global throttling rules up over in this main section up here for everything, including the replication jobs. By default, it's just going to go from the source to the target directly. Now, if you wanted to, you could use the built-in WAN acceleration. Now, Veeam's built-in WAN acceleration is specifically meant to help backup copy jobs and replication perform better. It's not to help your web traffic or help with, you know, other data services over remote networks. It's specifically built for Veeam functions. So if you're limited on bandwidth, you might want to consider using that. I don't have that in this environment, so I'm just going to go with direct. And then I'm going to set a schedule. So when it comes to a schedule, you could set a time. But one thing about setting a time is you have to know that in this example, remember, I selected the replicas will be built from the backups. Well, I have to know that the backup job isn't running then and that it's done, right? So maybe I'll do something like this. I'll do it after the cyber recovery assets backup job. So I'll take the backup and then build the replica, right? So that's a really clean flow after taking the backup and then sending it off to be replicated offsite. And this is an important thing as well. Terminate the job outside of the allowed window. So by default, 24 hours a day, these types of jobs are allowed to run. But if for whatever reason, like business reasons, you say, you know what, this is our busiest part of the day in the early morning or something like that, on these days of the week, you could say it cannot run at that time. And that'll protect your service levels or your production infrastructure. So you have a lot of control over that. And I'm going to go ahead and run this when I'm done here and build those replicas. So making data replication with Veeam is really easy. Virtual machines can be replicated offsite, just that easy. Now, if you like what you see, go over to Veeam.com. You can download a fully functioning trial or the community edition. You can get started making replications, having these additional types of recovery options. It's really attractive because a replica has a couple of really interesting characteristics. The recovery time objective is really good with a replica because it's just powering on a ready-to-go virtual machine. And the recovery point objective from both CDP and regular replicas give you a lot of control with that as well. So if you like what you see, go on over to Veeam.com and download a trial today.